Good morning, everyone. On behalf of the Director NIRC ATMA, Mr. Kapil Tandon, and members of the Core Committee, it gives me great pleasure to welcome all of you to the 10th meet. Our speaker is Mr. Tanmay, and the topic for discussion is technical analysis for different time frames. Tanmay is a CFA and a CMT. So he is a master of two disciplines, fundamental analysis and technical analysis. So I'm sure we are going to really gain a lot of knowledge out of this seminar. And without taking too much of time, I would like to invite Tanmay, please, to give his seminar. Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. So, when last time I was here, I think I did the market outlook thing. And now I have been given the responsibility for taking you through the basics of technical analysis. And today's session, I think it would mostly be regarding the basics of technicals, and those who are already using technicals or they are having, say, like analysts and all that, they may find it little kind of revision kind of thing. But still, I would do my best to explain the basics. See, market is always full of surprises for us, and every day we get to learn something. So it is very important that we learn every day, each and every day. And we do mistakes, everybody does mistakes. But for understanding markets, there are so many things, like short stories they have. I will just go through one of them. There was a village called Manipur. Okay, so all the people were very sincere and hardworking, and everybody wants to make money, definitely. So there once came a guy there, and he told them that I want to buy monkeys. So if you can bring me monkeys, then I would pay $1,000 for each one of the monkeys. So everybody gets together and starts searching for monkeys. They go to the forests, they search for the trees. Somebody goes to Hanuman temples also. And they search so many monkeys there, and they bring up them. So he stays there for a week or two, and he gets all those monkeys, pays $1,000 for each monkey, and goes back. But before going back, he tells them that I'm gonna come back after 3 months. And so they wait for him, and after 3 months he comes back, and he tells them that this time I'm going to buy your monkeys at 1200 rupees a piece. So again, everybody starts searching for them, and wherever they can find, they bring all of them and give it to him. He gets them into the cage, and he pays $1,200 and goes back. Again, he says, I will come back after 6 months, and this time I will pay 2,000 rupees per monkey. So now everybody gets very greedy at this point. And they say that already we have taken money two times, you know, from this person. And this time we have to find more monkeys so that we can make a lot of money. And even if we spend some money in bringing the monkeys, it is not a problem, because we are getting the assured returns of 2,000 rupees per monkey. So they get together again, but they cannot find enough monkeys, because already two times he had bought everything. So what happens that some other guy comes to their place in a month, and he tells them that I want to sell monkeys, and I'm going to sell you monkeys for $1,500. So everybody gets interested again, that now after 5 months, this person is going to come and he's going to buy from us at 2,000 rupees. And we are getting today at 1,500. Anyway, we are not getting it anywhere else, because we have searched in every forest and we are not getting any monkeys. So if he's selling us at 1,500, then we can get very good returns, around 20-25% in just a matter of 5 months. So they buy all the monkeys from that person at 1,500 rupees. And after that, that person and the first person, they are never seen only. So what is the moral of the story is that they bought the monkeys at 1,000 and 1,200, and they sold at 1,500. And people got stuck up with monkeys at 1,500. And then they got the returns and they went away. So this is, market goes like this only. that whenever the stock is very hot and you are damn sure about it, that it is going to move because it has already moved, and you search for more returns, and then it doesn't happen actually. And when the stock is in very bad shape, and actually that is the time to buy, that has been proved by so many things. And there was a quote by Warren Buffett regarding this, that Mr. Market is a maniac. He will buy things from you at sky high prices, but you should know that it is time to sell. And he will be ready to sell you for a song also, but you should be ready to buy at that time. So that is the most important thing. The market goes against the logic many times. We see that a good result has come, but the stock can fall down. And a bad result can prop the stock up also. So there is no one-to-one correspondence with news. So how does market go? You know this Sir Isaac Newton. He was a famous scientist who got this gravity theory. So he also invested in stock markets. And he lost heavily in that South Sea bubble of 1720s. And he said after that I can calculate the movement of the stars, but I cannot measure the madness of men. So it is like the stock market goes. And what is more important is that we have to understand the simple things. Making it too complicated sometimes does not work. You have to keep things simple, and you have to keep your systems ready, that you have to follow a method for the stock market. You need to have discipline. There are so many things to follow in the stock market. And if you follow it rigorously, then only one can be successful in it. So main thing is like this was John Maynard Keynes. He was the famous economist. He spoke about how stock market works. Okay, he said that it is like a beauty contest. But this beauty contest is different. It is not like a beauty pageant what we have. It is like, say, you are given 100 faces of beautiful women, and you have to choose 6 of the prettiest. Okay. So you can give your bet, but the person who gives 6 prettiest faces is not going to win. The person who gives 6 faces that are the most popular 6 faces is going to win. So it is like, we can go to third degree also. So what is the theme regarding this? That you should not choose what you like. You should choose what the psychology of the people is there, or what most of the things are saying you, that the group of investors, what they are going to like. And you can go to a second degree, that what group of investors are going to like, what other group of investors are going to like.